These right here, that's shale. It could be Carboniferous Permian period shales. And these are the ones that you would find fossils in. This here is a younger shale. Wow, what a huge difference. It's actually warm and the sunlight is hot. It's actually hot. Whoever still has an ice shack out on the river, they better get it off quick. March 21st is the spring solstice. What is this? Piece of shale, but from the way it was laying, it almost resembled the back of a fossil shell. I was hoping to find something down here. That white stone isn't stone. That is chalk. It's chalk, natural chalk. I'm hoping to find more than natural chalk. Maybe some plant fossils would be nice, or a fossil shell, or indigenous artifact. There's a seagull there. This is only one or two of them there. The others must be on the sandbar. There's a few of them out there. The big flock isn't here, that's for sure. All right. Now, I'll head out across around the point and check the ravines. Yeah. That could be a possible fossil. It looks like the letter Y. That might be a seed fern fossil, I don't know. Even if it is, I'm not dragging that stone from there. I'm just gonna leave it. I think that's just a mineral though. Just the way that some mineral is running through. Sand and old logs or old wooden beams. Here's a fourth one, looks like. And no seals. I don't know where the seals went. I only saw one seal. I videoed a lot more seals last winter. Let's see if I can get lucky up along this edge. A piece of pipe stem or something. That would be nice. And a little nodule of a gate. Like shale, but it doesn't have any, no sign of fossil on it. No coral markings anyway, but I mean. Yeah, I bought the that wooden cane with the tortoise motif. I bought that. $20. That was a cheap price. I'll save that cane on a wall. I might even donate it to St. John the Baptist Science Discovery Science Program. The artwork on it, the turtle, is very old artwork. It might be a modern reproduction, of the turtle symbol, but the turtle symbol never changed for thousands of years, so. Yeah, I'll think about it. And the boss has a long weekend. I guess the 18th is family day. There's no classes. Oh, that's all pretty. That seaweed's pretty sick. I'll just leave it. And now we'll go around that point to the front ravines. Hopefully there will be something there. I must have looked at this spot here two or three times today. I didn't really find anything. I should have brought the other trekking pole. This one here is not so easy to move seaweed with. The seagulls all flying somewhere. That's strange. Why are they leaving now? They're leaving early. Oh, I know what they're doing. Why, the pilot boat going up there now. What they're going to do is they're going to look for signs of fish stirred up by the pilot boat. That's why they're flying up there. They're fishing. It's just one way they do it. All right. Okay, back to what I was doing. Walk in paradise. Warming up. There's a lot less mist coming off these sea leaves. Steam. We call it steam. And I think that is that little rush of rollers is a sign of a turn in the tide. Now there's the eiders right there. Oh my goodness. Right in the mud. That's okay. That can be picked off. Well, it's kind of frozen on, but it will come clean. There was a change in current. A change in the current caused the caused these little tidal rollers. You can tell by the foam in the water. And that's a pretty powerful current out there. If you were in a rowboat or a canoe, that would carry you out toward the mouth of the harbor at about 20 miles an hour. Something like that. Oh, that's get back on the road again. Yeah, that mud is frozen on me now. I'll wait till I get home to wipe it off again. In the sweet old summertime. It'll be nice to come down. The sunset will be at 9:30 then. In the, 9:30 p.m. Almost 10 p.m. before dusk hits. This is one crevice. You never know what you find. It'd be sweet to walk up here and find a whole bunch of stray pearls. But for some reason, this year, I have not seen the dredgers out a lot. I think I have maybe 4 videos of the dredgers, while last year I had 15 or 20. Something along that line anyway. I'll have to wait and see what the dredger operations are like in March. And they will be out for sure. A lot of silt will be carried down the St. John River system and it will end up in the harbor. No. What is this? I don't know if that's an accident or an actual something. I think that is an accident. But if you were desperate for a point, to use in hunting, all you have to do to give it an edge, you just keep on, just keep on rubbing it. There you go, yes. Just keep going back and forth and you can put a sharper edge on that, no problem. Sharp enough so that if it was used with force, it would make a hole in whatever you want it to make a hole in. Or just like on a loan, do some percussion napping of some kind of stone material and you can make something with a cutting edge easily enough. Here's the front ravine. Hopefully there will be a fossil or something here, or a bead, or pipe stem. But I'm just glad to get out for the exercise. And this is why you try to keep a careful eye on things. Glass. If you don't want to replace your boots on a constant basis, always keep your eye open for glass. What is this? Okay, first. put that out of the way. Oh, it's an old shell. Yeah. It's not a fossil, but it's a very old shell. An old clam fossil. Oh, gosh. Oh, well. A little dirt never hurt it. It won't be the first time these pipes get dirty. This is extremely light. It's actually shale, rotted shale. Old, from the Carboniferous period. Oh, please, that could be something here. I may as well finish checking up in that area. A lot of the ground is still pretty stiff and cold. Yeah. I should have brought the other stick. I could have gone through this seaweed no problem. I'll check out down there. Shells and clam shells and whelks. but no beads or pipes then. Yeah, and there's mud and a mud build up. Looking fine. Alright, I'm gonna have to warm up this camera. Well, before I do, I'll just walk down here a few yards. See if there's anything. I hope there is. That's a 70s bottle. An old 7-Up 70s bottle, I think. They took the pop-off cap. Kinds of seagull prints. All right. Yes, I'm going to warm up the camera. I will see you online.